you up to the top of the park and look down. I'm a princess, and this is my kingdom. I'm a princess, and this is my crown. She thought, staring at cars glistening and the speed bumps below. Grey clouds mottled hanging over the rooftops. Sitting on the bench, she had to pull her jacket tight. The sun was gone. The trees down where she sat the spring before had grown moss, so she lay in the grass. She hoped if she lay there long enough, then someone would find her. After about an hour, nobody came, so she stood up and walked the long way home down Morel Avenue. When she got indoors, it started to rain. She was thinking about the party she was at the night before. Someone there had said that there were some people upstairs lying in a line on the floor in the dark. They were high. She said, like, who? They said, everyone. She assumed by this that they meant anyone who was cool. Well, the thing was, they were on uppers, and she really couldn't think of a worse combination. People in Oxford didn't know how to do drugs. So she went into the kitchen. The guy she'd come to the party with was ignoring her because this other girl he liked was there. He loves her, she thought. What's worse was, she didn't really care. Perched by the microwave, smoke from a cigarette got up her nose. These two girls had been giving her uglies all night. An hour had passed as he continued to thrust himself into her. Knickers pinching her thighs, jagged hip bones. Some holiday eating all seafood in the backseat of her brain. She waited until it was over. He got up and buckled her. She stared at his face in the dark. Some glassy eyeballs caught the light on the young. She thought how romantic this could have been. She imagined him stroking her face, and he was gone. She lay staring at the ceiling, cars stalled on the street below, and the song was called your name, but in fact she might have different syllables colliding. It wasn't hers, she thought. She lay there trying to figure out the tune.